In this module, we're going to talk about the analytics portion of Azure and some of the service offerings we have up there to do kind of deep learning, advanced analytics, if you will, in Azure, along with some of the storage that kind of goes along with something that would service an analytics suite of tools. So Ed actually works a lot with this technology, and I kind of wanted to get some insight from you on what are some of the prominent pieces in Azure for the analytics side of things?
Sure. So within Azure, we have a few different analytics technologies that we can use. And typically, what you see with MPP or massively parallel processing, it's typically at customers you'll see Hadoop. And what we have is HD Insight, which is a PaaS version of Hadoop. But our HD Insight clusters actually have four different types. So we have the Hadoop, which is a basic MapReduce framework. But we also have something like HBase, which is low latency reads and writes. We have Storm, which is complex event processing or near real-time analytics. And we also have Spark, which a lot of folks use. It's similar to Hadoop, but it has a core engine, and there's a lot of different processing frameworks on top of that. So you have Spark SQL, Spark ML, you have a graph framework. So a lot of different APIs all within the same ecosystem, so you don't have to go off and grab different pieces from different technologies. So HD Insight has been typically our workhorse for Azure Analytics, more advanced analytics. And what we are running HD Insight on top of is just basic Azure storage. But now we have, in preview, we have Azure Data Lake. And with that, we have Azure Data Lake Store, which is another distributed store, very similar to our storage, except it's a little bit more robust. Whereas with storage, you have kind of limits on number of storage counts, number of containers, number of blobs you can have, or the size. With Data Lake Store, there are none of these limits. So you can have any number of files, any size, your Data Lake Store can just go infinitely. And it also has a web HDFS layer on top of that. So any application that you have that uses the HDFS layer of a Hadoop cluster or HD Insight cluster, and HDFS is Hadoop Distributed File System, you can use that web HDFS API to basically go get that data or to point your application at the Data Lake Store to access that data. And then the other piece of Data Lake is Data Lake Analytics. And what that is basically another analytics service where you can run, it's transaction based. So you can run your USQL queries, and USQL is a newer language that's kind of a combination of typical SQL workloads. So you have typical create statements and typical SQL statements, but you have that mixed in with user defined functions or UDFs from C Sharp. So you have both the functionality of C Sharp that you can combine with SQL to make it pretty powerful. And you submit these jobs on a job basis, so you don't have to write a huge script to do it. You can write a huge script to do it, but I mean you typically submit these jobs on a per job basis. What that does is it runs on top of Azure Data Lake Store. And another piece of Azure Data Lake Store is now you can add that to an HD Insight cluster as well. So HD Insight can actually run on top of Azure Data Lake Store as well, and not just on top of the regular storage account. And then we also have different services, the machine learning services. So we have Azure ML, which is kind of a self-service ML. You can drag and drop modules into your Azure ML model, and you can create an experiment and score that experiment, and then you can create a scoring experiment and a web service endpoint where you can create that endpoint, and then in your application, you can send data to that endpoint to get it scored, and then have that come back to you. So you can have that predictive analytics module there, and you can import different modules like R modules. If you already have R code from your data scientist, or you already have Python code, you can import those modules into Azure ML as well, and then run it through there. We just recently released cognitive APIs, which is a lot of, there's speech APIs, there's facial recognition APIs, there's text analytics APIs to do a lot of different things. You could do Lewis models to parse out commands and learn what different commands are. So basically you would create an API, a cognitive API account on your Azure subscription, and then you can, there's different tiers for how you get billed but you can send a certain amount of transactions to that API to get that score or to analyze whatever that may be, whether it's photos or text or what have you. And then we also have Azure Data Factory, which is kind of an orchestration piece of all of these different services. And what that does is it kind of points to where your data lives, if it lives on premises or if it lives in your storage accounts or whatever. And you can also connect it to different services like HD Insight or like Azure ML and Azure Data Lake, and you can transform your data there. And that orchestrates everything. It puts it on a nice timely schedule, and you can see everything from one pane of glass. So if your pipeline ends up failing in one region, you can see that and you can drill down into that and you can understand why your pipeline failed, what happened. You see the error code right there in the Azure portal, and then you can go fix that and rerun that pipeline and can continue that pipeline continuity from end to end. We also have Azure SQL Data Warehouse, which is kind of an alternative to Azure SQL Database, which is a PaaS version of SQL Server. And so Azure SQL Data Warehouse is a PaaS version of basically what we have on premises is called APS or Analytics Platform System. But you have a parallel data warehouse, which is massively parallel processing within SQL. And then you also have a Hadoop region. In this case, it would be something like blob storage. So within Azure SQL Data Warehouse, you can create tables on top of data that's stored in blob storage without having to import that into SQL Data Warehouse first, which makes it a little bit faster, and it's another schema on read instead of schema on write there. And pretty soon that will be able to extend into Azure Data Lake Store as well, so not just limited to Azure Storage.
Yeah, so one question I had, Ed, was it seems to me that in the analytics space, there's actually there's two different kind of models there. One is kind of a batch processing, which I look at like HD Insight
right. And
Hadoop Technologies doing MapReduce. That's kind of a batch type. It's not a real time. So it's like we go run this job, like you said, we schedule jobs to run and we run the jobs, we get the output, and then we do something with that output. What about like on the real time processing, the ones you mentioned, or any of those real time, or I know we have like stream analytics, but is there any other ones that you mentioned there that do more real-time processing as opposed to batch or that?
Right, yeah. So we do have Azure Stream Analytics, which is a near real-time processing engine. But we also have, with HC Insight clusters, you have one of our cluster types is a Storm cluster, mm-hmm. which is a real-time processing engine where you basically write what's called bolts and spouts, which will process your stream of data or your tuples coming in of data. And you can do that in Java or C#. But you just write basically tiny programs that transform those tuples of data coming in, streaming data. We also have our Spark clusters have one of the frameworks within Spark is Spark Streaming. Mm-hmm. So you can do that as well, where you have your Spark application, but what it does is it actually processes your data or your stream of data as micro batches. So it's still kind of batch processing, but it does it on a much smaller scale, where it's more near real-time processing for that more complex event processing.
What about the cognitive APIs you mentioned? Are those services something that could be done real-time, or is that something you do kind of batch, like you batch up some data and send it over, or can you actually feed like real data into it real-time?
You can feed real data into it, so you can do it kind of a one-off where you're sending commands to a Lewis model or something like that, where you're basically inputting a command and it'll feed you back the answer of what it thinks that command is, and then you can do that.
Awesome.
So that wraps up our module on Azure Analytics.